everyone. My name is Stefania, and I'm the new general manager for CCP in Iceland. I'm in the process of moving from Shanghai to Iceland now, because I've been spending the last 3 years in Shanghai as the development director for CCP in Shanghai, overseeing projects like e-online and Gunjack. Before moving to Shanghai, I worked at the Reykjavik office here, being the development director for e-online. Now, e-online was launched in 2003. It's a massively multiplayer online game in a universe that we call New Eden, but I'm going to refer to it as the Eve universe. It has a rich backstory, and its scalability is endless. And a lot of incredible stories happen within Eve Online. And the Eve universe has been the playground for both the players and us, the developers, for the last 13 years. There is more happening in the Eve universe than Eve Online. But as I said, here you see the three main characters of three of our games. In the middle, you see the Eve pilot. And the next game set in the Eve universe is Dust 514. It was released in 2013 on PlayStation 3. In Dust, Eve and Dust players are playing on the same servers. All combat takes place in real time on planets that you can find in the Eve universe. And on the left, you see Raun, the main character in Eve Valkyrie. I hope you all tried Eve Valkyrie out here. Valkyrie came out on Oculus and Vive already, and is coming out on PlayStation VR in October. Back to the Eve universe. There is a character that you don't see on this picture. He is somewhere deep in space. There is a Gunjack fiercely fighting against enemy waves coming at him. He's defending the mining operation of his corporation. That's the guy. He's a blue-collar worker in the Eve universe. He's just an individual cog in the big machine. And Gunjack the game is an arcade shooter built from the ground up for Gear VR. And it has been ported to Oculus, to Vive, and it's coming on PlayStation in October. Until now, it is the best-selling VR game on the market, with 450,000 units sold. Over 450,000 units sold, was I supposed to say here? So I led the production team in Shanghai making Gunjack, and I would like to tell you a little bit more about this journey and about the development. The team started experimenting with Gear VR at the time, around the time it was announced. We got the Samsung headset, and we started to try it out, and we realized the quality of this headset is so that we could foresee that we could make a fully-fledged game on this. And us having worked on Eve and on Dust, which are very community-driven games, it has gotten somehow into CCP's DNA to listen to players' feedback. And I think that was that's a very important part of this, because when we then took on to do a client game on a mobile in VR, which we had never done before, we knew we would apply the same method. We would play test and listen to feedback. And at FanFest 2015, we brought a prototype, we had people test, we had several other tests outside of CCP and so on. But when one of those things that we wanted to do was to make the game very accessible, we wanted everyone to be able to play it all the time. So what, in a playtest, for example, if we saw people take the headset off and like, hey, what am I supposed to do next? We knew we were not nailing it, so we had to go back, change things, and just till it felt right. And doing all those playtests, it's a lot of work. But in the end, we know that it was all worth it, all those playtests. Then here you see a high-level timeline for the production of Gunjack. of course, the faces are not proportion to time. It's all in a different, you know. But just for you to get an idea. We decided in the beginning we wanted to be on Samsung Gear VR on day one. And as we started during concept and prototype, the launch date had not been announced yet at that point, so we knew we had a moving target. But what we knew then was that we, in every phase, we had to be focused. We had to focus on the things that mattered the most in each phase. So during concept and prototype, we were very much focused on getting the experience right. And for example, we made the choice of doing this in Unreal 4, which we were then super happy about during prototype because we could use blueprints to iterate very fast. And that was, you know, it helped to make good decision in the beginning. So, for example, when we went then through vertical slice, it's very tempting to go and solve all the problems to begin with. Like, we knew we would have to work with the memory because the memory started to get, you know, more and more, and the client got bigger and bigger during vertical slice. But we were like, okay, vertical slice is about getting a game experience, you know, from the beginning that you start the game until you end, sort of. Like, you pick a vertical slice to go through. And coming out of vertical slice, the client was just too big. It's just how it is. We went into pre-production, and in pre-production, we did research spikes to address those things in production. Reduce the size of the client, work on performance, replace the blueprints with actual code, and so on. So my point is, we did this in short time because we were focused, and also in pre-production, we had to scope. We just had to scope the game because at that point, we knew when we were going to launch it. We did a production plan with art assets and all coming in, and we knew how much time we had, and we knew we had to scope. So we scoped in a clever way, I hope, because what then happened is that the game comes out and the reviews are really good. And I did not see anyone say, hey, they probably scoped out 5 enemies. Like, so we were really happy to see that all the effort that we put into this, because it was a lot of effort, and that people appreciated it. Then during the production, we held tight to the idea of immersion and presence. We wanted to get the player in the mindset of him being the Gunjack. And one example how we did that was that we used cinematic experiences to put you in the mindset like, I'm the Gunjack, I'm going to have to go out and fight. We also realized that audio and story plays a huge part in getting this presence, having people to feel like they're there. So even though we did not have a lot of time to do Gunjack, we managed to do some scripting and got some voice acting to tell the story. And Gunjack has a story. And I think that's so important. It's a simple arcade game, it still has a story and a deeper meaning. So what I want to do, show you the boot up sequence. Can you turn up the volume?
The turret is calibrated to react to your head movement. Let's show these pirates they picked the wrong mining operation to mess with. Remember, stay calm, pick your targets, and most importantly, kill them all.
And then you start shooting the enemy waves. It was also important for us, Gunjack being this arcade shooter, that we have some humor in it. So, I think it was a good choice that when we did the script, we wanted to have some, you know, stupid jokes in it, and it has it. And what we were so happy about also is that also people playing the game noticed this, and that's the most important thing, that people noticed this. And this is from the Polygon review. CCP knows how to make the game seem much bigger than it actually is by using the lore from EVE Online and some above average voice acting and writing. You feel like you're part of a larger world. This is the review where I got the tears in my eyes. I wanted people to feel like they were part of this world. And so, yeah. And it's simple dialogues and it's simple applications of the voice acting, but it worked. So the best part about working on a game like this is to work with a great team that wants to innovate, that wants to push boundaries. And this team now is working on Next Gunjack. Next Gunjack is coming on Google Daydream later this year. And I'm really looking forward to see that. And then CCP is not only innovating inside the EVE universe. There's a super clever team in Atlanta working on a project called Project Arena. Project Arena is a full body VR experience where two players throw discs at each other. You either throw them directly at people or you have them bounce off walls. But that's pretty much all I can tell you about this project. We can all look forward to playing this game one day. Thank you.